And a slew of new movies headed to the theaters this weekend. Sly Stallone and his A-list pals prove they are anything but expendable for the third time. A classic novel makes its big screen debut. Two new girl stars see what it's like to be cops. And there's a movie that took 12 years to shoot. Louis B. Hobson here to break down all the new releases. Let's start with the biggie, The Expendables 3.
Things blow up real good and real often. It's a lot of fun. I mean, it is. You know what you're getting before you even buy your ticket. The big surprise in it for me was Antonio Banderas. He steals the movie. He's so funny. He's doing his Puss in Boots character from Shrek. I mean, he really is. And he's such an obnoxious little thing. And you know why everybody, all the other guys, hate him so much. But he's so desperate to be accepted.
It's funny because on one hand, you know, you see the people, I'm sure, are clamoring to be in these films because it's such a great cast. On the other hand, he's also hiring his friends who nobody else will hire.
That's
like Wesley Snipes. And like Mel Gibson.
And Mel Gibson, absolutely. I mean, and all the in-jokes on that, too. Because at the beginning, they're breaking Wesley Snipes out of prison. So, you know, and he talks about what it was like to be in prison. And so there's those kind of in-jokes. And Mel Gibson gives this huge speech about what it's like to be right in with the government, and then they throw you under the bus.
Right.
And so you have to become a villain. So it's great fun. And as I say, things blow up very big and very often.
So for the cast and for the action, I would definitely check
it
out.
Oh, yeah, fun thing.
Next up, The Giver. So this, Jeff Bridges and Meryl Streep, two of the greatest actors of our generation. What's Taylor Swift doing in this movie? Please tell
me. You know what? And I didn't even know she was in it. The hair color is different, everything. She has a small role, but she's very, very good in it.
Okay.
This is the, you know, we see Hunger Games now and Divergent, and these are huge. But this book preceded them all.
Mm-hmm.
This was the first of the novels about, for young adults, what it's like maybe in the future.
Right.
And what she did was take 1984 and Brave New World, combined it with Logan's Run, and you have The Giver.
Right.
Jeff Bridges bought it 20 years ago. He wanted to direct it with his father playing The Giver. He could not get funding for 20 years.
Jeff Bridges can't get funding in Hollywood.
Exactly.
What is wrong with this
exactly.
World?
And so now he's playing The Giver himself.
Oh wow, interesting.
I found it very, very intriguing. I like what it has to say, except for the ending. I don't buy the ending.
Okay.
But they painted themselves into a corner with that one.
Okay, people will still head out to see it.
Yes,
though,
yes, yes.
Let's Be Cops, another, you know, silly cop movie, or is it actually funny?
No. I mean, I went to the screening on Wednesday and people laughed uproariously. They just stoop so low for the laughs. And after a while, you realize, you know, all of this is ludicrous. I mean, I know comedy's, I mean, ludicrous, but, I mean, they put themselves in such unbelievable danger impersonating policemen.
Right.
I you know, come on, watch it on TV, watch it on DVD, watch it, but, you know, it's going to be big. Judging from it had a huge opening on Wednesday.
Oh, it's already.
Oh yeah, it's already opened. It opened on Wednesday.
Okay, and can't gloss over this. Boyhood. This is a Richard Linklater film that was shot over the course of 12 years. I can't even fathom
with this. Ethan Hawke and Rosanna Arquette playing this young boy's parents. They're separated. And they meet for special occasions. And those were the occasions that were filmed over the 12 years. And of course, this child is growing into a young man. And you watch that happen. And it's not huge, momentous things that happen in his life. It's just ordinary things. But you know what? They've happened to all of us. And so that's where the appeal in the film is. We see ourselves in this young man. And the movie is almost 3 hours long, and yet you don't realize it because you're so engrossed in this child's life.
Wow.
And watching this young actor grow. And for me, the most startling thing is when you first see him, how could this child be the, you know, how could these be his parents? But that's always in movies. And then at the end, when he's 18, he looks like Ethan Hawke, for heaven's sake.
So they've all grown into each other.
He's grown, that's right. And that's part of that thing about we take on the look of our parents because we begin imitating them. It's a beautiful, beautiful film, and I guarantee you, come Oscar nomination time, you will hear about this movie in almost every category. So see it now.
Okay, Boyhood, Richard Linklater. That's all we have time for. Louis B. Hobson, thank you very much for this.